My dear children, this is the continuation module of mobile organization, the functional components. In this module, I am going to deal with RF trans receiver. Actually, RF transceiver is connected with your SIM, that is subscriber identification module. What is the use of RF transceiver? What is RF? Already I told, RF is radio frequency. Transceiver means it is a combined device. That is, it can both transmit as well as receive. That is, RF transceiver is used for receiving and sending radio signals from mobile device or to the mobile device with a mobile network, that is a tower. Actually, our SIM is connected with any mobile tower. So, who is responsible for transmitting signals or receiving signals? That is RF transceiver. Look at the picture. Of one of the example of RF transceiver is radiometrics TDL2A 433-9. Look at the modem speed it is given, 9600 BPS. What is BPS? It is bits per seconds. Bits per seconds. The next device or the next component we need to discuss is a subscriber identity module. It is an integrated circuit that stores international mobile subscriber identity number, that is IMSI number, and it is a related key which are used to identify and authenticate subscribers on mobile telephony device. What do you mean by authenticate? That is only one subscriber per SIM. So that person having the authentication of that particular SIM. Where the SIM is connected with? Into a mobile telephony device. It is also possible to store contact informations on many SIM cards. Nowadays, we are having different types of SIM cards. A full SIM, mini SIM, micro SIM, nano SIM, and an embedded SIM. While we are discussing all these types, what is the main difference among these? The size of the SIM card, that is full SIM, nowadays it is not in use. Either for the time being we may use mini SIM, micro SIM or nano SIM. Where the embedded SIM is using? It is in Apple Watch, that is smart watch. I think you are all clear about what is radio transceiver and a SIM. Thank you.